Hi guys, and welcome to today's oil painting time lapse and studio sessions episode 28. And right now there's a special holiday sale going on at my shop, and you can use the code HOLIDAY at happyd-artist.com to get 15% off your entire order plus a free mystery gift. The sale ends December 25th and the URL is happyd-artist.com. And more importantly, this holiday season, I'm trying to raise $1,000 for one of my favorite charities, the ASPCA, which stands for the American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. They're a nonprofit organization that rescues and rehomes so many adorable pets all across the country. So 25% of all sales in my shop this month will be donated to the ASPCA. Alrighty, today's painting is featuring my lovely cat Boogerface, and I came up with this idea when I was doing some concept sketches for an upcoming show. The piece is actually currently on view at Arch Enemy Arts in Philadelphia, and the theme was wintry blues. So I had, of course, an idea to do something featuring like a snowy blue background, but I also wanted to do something a little bit different. And I was at home and helping my mom bake a cake, and I was whipping the frosting, and I suddenly thought about how the frosting resembled snow because it was snowing outside our window. And then I had this idea to put a cake inside a snowy environment. And of course, if there's food, there's always going to be a mischievous cat lurking in the corner waiting to steal the food. And that's why I put my cat Boogerface as the subject of this painting, because she is known for always stealing food from our plates. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this time lapse. And today I really wanted to chat about something that has been on my mind lately. As I was preparing to edit this video, I was taking a look at some of my channel statistics, if you will, from my YouTube channel, and I noticed that around this time last year, I was uploading a lot more frequently. I just seemed to have, I don't know, maybe more time or more energy or something, but it just seems to me that I was way more productive last year and I was able to generate content for YouTube, Instagram, and Patreon and keep up with all of that, while still doing a lot of paintings for clients and for shows. And this year, even though it is again the holiday season, I just feel like I'm always running out of time. I feel like I'm burnt out or the deadlines are stressing me out, and I'm just not as productive as I used to be. I'm not generating as much content as I used to, and because of that, my growth has slowed down. You know, I'm not gaining new subscribers or new views as fast as I used to. I'm not getting new Instagram followers as fast as I used to. And all these negative thoughts were clouding my head. And I suddenly realized just how toxic that way of thinking is. You know, I always try to preach, encouragement and confidence, but at times I also fall victim to negative thoughts. And today was one of those days. So this is going to be a very candid, raw discussion. And you know, I apologize in advance if I say things that you may disagree with, but these are just based on my personal experiences, my personal opinions. But yeah, I just realized today when I was stressing over how I'm not as productive and not creating as much content or uploading as many videos as I used to this time last year, I suddenly realized that these are sources of stress and concern that never ever used to even cross my mind. Back in the day when art was just a hobby, all I worried about was, will I have time today to create a piece of art? And I didn't really care if I shared it with anyone. I didn't care if anyone liked it. I didn't care if it brought me any, you know, views or money. All I cared about was the process of creating art as an outlet for my stress, you know, as a way to relax and unwind after a long day of stress from working at my desk job. And now that art has become a job, sometimes art itself can be a source of stress. You know, a huge source of stress for me is deadlines. And my biggest fear is to be late on something, whether it's a painting or shipping prints or even uploading videos. I still try to maintain one video a week. And over time, as the deadlines pile on more and more, and I think I say yes to more and more projects, or I guess hold myself to a higher standard, The stress of the deadlines is more palpable in my mind. So when I wake up in the morning and sit down at my desk or at my easel, instead of having that genuine kind of pure enthusiasm of just wanting to create that day, sometimes it's coupled with a feeling of stress and pressure, like, oh my gosh, am I gonna have enough time today to finish everything I need to do before the week is up? You know, is the post office going to be super busy and my packages will get delayed? Or am I going to have enough time to package and prepare everything for when I travel? Or, you know, is me slowing down going to negatively affect my livelihood? Is it going to slow down my momentum? And am I going to lose followers or disappoint people because I'm not creating as much content, or maybe not making content that's interesting enough or fresh enough or new enough? And all these little seeds of doubt, all these little sources of pressure and stress began associating with art. You know, back in the day when art was just a hobby, all I could think about when it was time to create was joy and relaxation and just a very therapeutic experience where I could relax and unwind. And now when I think about art, it is still all of those positive things, but it also have another list of stress and pressure tacked onto it. So in that way, it's not as fun as when it's just a hobby, because you need to rely on your art to pay the rent. So when you rely on something for your survival, you definitely create a lot of pressure around it. And, you know, if you have a bad month, it's hard to avoid really questioning your art and questioning yourself. You know, like if I go through a month where I don't make as much money or grow enough views as the previous month, I'll look at my artwork that I made that month and say, well, maybe my paintings were not as good, or maybe, you know, my subjects are too boring and I should have created something new. And, you know, all these little sources of doubt and discouragement begin kind of polluting the love you have for art. And honestly, it's so silly, because the amount of attention you receive on social media or the amount of sales you make isn't always solely or directly influenced by the type of art you make. Social media and any sort of advertising is very unpredictable. There's no way you can guarantee good results with, you know, a specific formula. A lot of times it's up to luck and up to chance. And, you know, it's so silly for me, and I do this all the time, like I am not immune to negative thoughts, even though I try my best to always have a positive outlook. But sometimes, you know, I am victim to questioning my art. If I'm not doing as well this month as I am last month, I wonder if maybe the art I made this month wasn't as good, wasn't as detailed, or wasn't as polished, or wasn't as creative. And it sucks, and I need to stop thinking that way. So yeah, in that sense, it's not as fun as when it was a hobby, because now I have all this, like, all these sources of pressure and doubt and stress because I need to rely on my art to keep myself afloat. However, I will say, and I want to end the video on a positive note, that in some ways it is so much more fun to have as a career, because of the type of pressure and deadlines and the amount you have to really push yourself. I think my art has grown and improved so much faster than it was when I was doing it as a hobby. When art was just a hobby for me, I used it as a way to relax and unwind, and it wasn't a big deal if I slacked off or went, you know, a week without doing any art, or maybe didn't try as hard to improve. And of course, there's nothing wrong with that. I think it is so important to use art as a therapy tool, and also to not always put pressure on yourself every time you do art. You don't have to make a masterpiece every single time you create a new piece of artwork. But now that I do this as a career, I can't afford to slack off, you know, so because of that, I no longer slack off. Every time I sit down, I really do try to be the best artist I can be, and I really do try to make pieces that are different, that can encourage people, inspire people, make people go, wow. And because of that kind of good pressure, I really, really grown and pushed myself to be out of my comfort zone and really created a large body of work and just put in way more hours than when I was doing it as a hobby. You know, if I was tired or feeling lazy and I was simply doing art for fun, I sometimes might take the easy route and relax and watch Netflix or go out for happy hour instead of painting. But now that I do it as a career, I do it no matter what. I try to always fit in time for it. It's become a priority. And because it's a priority, I think it definitely shows in the amount that I have improved and the amount that I've grown in these past few years. So yeah, this is kind of my rambly analysis of art as a hobby versus art as a career. To sum it up, in some ways, art is more fun when it's a hobby because there's less pressure, but art is, in other ways, more fun when it's a career because it's exhilarating and you challenge yourself and push yourself to grow in ways that you never have grown before. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this time lapse and thanks for watching and listening to me. And before I leave, I just quickly wanted to announce that I have given my Patreon page a huge makeover. This past month, I have been working extra hard in trying to improve my rewards so that they can be catered towards what you guys want to see the most. So I've added so many new things, such as monthly video tutorials that are exclusive to patrons only, a longer 40-minute video podcast where I answer your questions about art career. There's also step-by-step tutorial guides and a peek into my secret sketchbook that I don't show anyone else, and so many more cool rewards. I would love it if you guys checked it out and joined my awesome Patreon family. You can go to patreon.com/happydartist. All right, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye!